In the previous episode, we flew 1,400 nautical miles before landing in Svolvær in the Lofoten Islands, after having diverted to Bodø due to weather. After three beautiful sunny days visiting the islands, we returned to Bodø to refuel before setting course for Oslo, or specifically the general aviation airfield, Kjeller. En route, we flew overhead Svartisen, the Black Glacier, and got a nice glimpse of it. That's about the last thing we saw before we zoomed up to flight level 200 to jump a front. After an hour of IMC, we popped out of the clouds into glorious sunshine. Approaching destination, we could see there were potential thunderstorms approaching Oslo from the southeast. I therefore changed my plan and chose to approach Kjeller from the west. We descended over the lake of Mjøsa, where we find the city of Lillehammer that hosted the Winter Olympics in 1994, and Hamar, where the inverted Viking ship where the skating events took place is located. Landing at Kjeller, I always feel a bit of nostalgia. That is where I discovered general aviation, where I got my pilot's license and flew during 5 years. This airfield is of historical significance to Norway, since it was the country's first airfield. Built in 1912, this is where explorer Roald Amundsen was awarded Norway's first ever pilot's license in 1914. It has been a military airfield where maintenance of Norway's F-16s took place. When the F-16s will have been phased out and replaced with F-35s, the future of the airfield is uncertain, and it is likely it may be closed within a few years. It is located some 10 nautical miles south of the Oslo International Airport. When approaching from the west, you cross the extended runway centerline just 1,000 feet below the approach path to runways 01.
Oh, I can close with you, Sierra Kilo. We have Nittedal inside, so you can close it now.
Remember Sierra Kilo, flaplan close at time 1447. Identification is terminated, and so you can change to local is approved.
We'll change frequency. Thanks for your help, November 325, Sierra Kilo.
Anytime.
Traffic November 325 Sierra Kilo Columbia 400 inbound from Nittedal, descending 1,800 feet. Expect runway 15. Correction, expect runway 12.
In Norway, you are allowed to perform a direct final, and since there seems to be a crosswind, I start a long final to runway 12, thereby avoiding overflying the Lillestrøm city center and reducing my noise footprint.
Kjeller, November 325 Sierra Kilo, straight in 12. Sidevind fra høyre. Okay, landed 5-2.
Got the Vartera.
Kjeller, Lima November Kilo Alpha Papa and holding Alpha. Entering and landing up runway 3-0.
Okay, but it ain't bad, that's all. Are it dark?
Yep. Ganske sikkert. Nå får vi se hvor vi parkerer. Vi kan titte fram her for å se om det plass. Ja, jeg tror det plass. Litt sånn reservert og sånn, ja, vi kan ta det siden.
det er parkert forrige gang.
After a few days of rest and relaxation with family and friends, we leave Kjeller heading for Bremen in Germany. We start by overflying the Oslo city center and the Oslo fjord.
Ago, when I was younger, I kinda liked a girl I knew. She was mine, and we were sweethearts. That was then, but then it's true. I'm in love with a fairy tale. Every night we fell in love. No one else could make me sadder, but no one else could lift me high above. Cannot find her, but when I do, we'll get a brand new start.
Thank you.
further south, on the Oslo fjord, we spot the fort of Oscarsborg that sank a German cruiser called Blücher, thereby delaying the invasion of Oslo during the night of April 9, 1940. It is time to say farewell to Norway and once again climb into the clouds for the crossing to Denmark and what the Norwegians call the continent. During the descent to Bremen, we encountered icing conditions. That actually does not happen too often. The first indication was ice on the windshield, then on the wings. The de-icing system coped with the ice on the leading edges. Warmer temperatures below took care of the windshield. After one night in Bremen, we take off again on our final leg to Pontoise.
Okay, engine instruments, airspeed, 60 knots. Knots, flaps up. Middle marker identified.
Where did that?
Middle marker.
What did you do?
One, 20 knots.
November 3250 kilo, descend flight level 80 to be level by Devin.
Flight level 80, November 3250 kilo. By Devin.
We're back in France and pretty soon on the ground in Pontoise.
Sierra Kilo, alors le F-35 en vol, ça donne quoi?
Ah, je l'ai pas testé personnellement, mais c'est assez joli en vol. Mais ça déchire les oreilles.
Ouais, j'ai vu la vidéo, mais ça. C'est vrai que bon, le son doit rendre différemment.
C'est assez fidèle en fait, avec ce déchirement juste après la remise de gaz.
Voilà.
Merci pour les vidéos et vous avez passé de belles vacances, j'ai l'impression.
Merci bien, c'est Akilo.
Alpha Golf, faites 180, remontez la 05, bravo, l'essence.
Allez, on fait 180, remonte 05.